Don't tell me I fucking chipped a nail. Oh, we're good. Let's do this shit. Howdy everyone, and welcome back to the Vulgar Kitchen. Today, I'm gonna be making some fantastic brownies. No, not the good kind, but they are gluten-free, so yay! I got a lot of ingredients here, so let me run through them real quick, and then we will get started. First, I have 1/4 cup of unsweetened cocoa powder, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract, 1/3 cup of cornstarch, 3/4 cup of sugar, 12 ounces of semi-sweet chocolate chippers, a little over a cup of these awesome, delicious Reese's peanut butter chips, 6 tablespoons of butter that I fucking hacked at, and just, they look really ridiculous, but you want your butter cut up, so 6 tablespoons of butter, and 3 large room temperature eggs. Now, I've already got my oven preheated to 350 degrees, so no excuses. We're just gonna fucking jump into this. Oh, I also have a pan here. I sprayed it with a little bit of nonstick cooking spray, and I put my parchment paper in just so it would help the parchment paper stick a little bit better. Okay, so we're gonna dive on in. First, I'm gonna dump my butter into my chocolate chips. And the butter's room temperature too. Throw this out. All right, now we're gonna microwave this because I love Chef Mike. He's a fantastic helper in the kitchen. 30 seconds first, I'm gonna give it a mix, see how well we're doing, and then I might need to pop it back in one more time. But we'll see. Boom. In the meantime, I'm going to mix together my dry ingredients. Now, I'm gonna kind of put these next to each other. Whenever you're baking with sugar, it's always considered a wet ingredient because when it heats, melts and it turns into caramel. That's fun fact for you if you didn't know that. Oh, well, I was blabbing too much. I didn't get a chance to mix yet. I'm gonna get like a spoon or something. A little spatula here. It's definitely gonna need to go in a little bit longer. Oh, I need a plate. All right. Back into the microwave for another 30 seconds. And now I'm going to mix together my dry ingredients. So I'm gonna put the cornstarch in with my cocoa powder. Oh, and I'm getting white shit everywhere. If the cops came, they'd think I just finished doing a lime or something. Scrape all that in. Cornstarch works as like a thickening agent, so that's what's gonna help hold together my brownies since I don't actually have flour in them. All right, in with the salt, and I'm just gonna give this a quick little whiskeroo, little whisker. Okay, cool. Perfect. Chocolate chip clumps out, so I think I'm gonna put it back in the microwave just maybe like 15 more seconds. Wow, that's messy. Get a knife here to help scrape. Okay, this is like not really working, but whatever. In with you again. 15 seconds. And I'll put these guys away.
Oh yeah, check out that cornstarch.
Don't do drugs. Now to get this. Looks perfect. Right consistency that I need it to be at. Okay. Now, with the help of TV magic, I put my sugar in and my vanilla and my 3 eggs one at a time, and I have it all nice and mixed, and holy shit, an eggshell. These brownies might not have wheat in them, but they got eggshells in them. Woo! All right, so now that we're all nice and mixed, as you can see here, I'm going to add in my dry ingredients. I'm just gonna plop her in. Oof. Oh, God. Ooh. Wow. Flying everywhere. All right. Looks good. Don't need you anymore. Now I'm just going to carefully mix in my dry ingredients as not to make this splatter all over creation. This is great because, of course, you know, if you've got any sort of gluten allergy or intolerance, boom, you can still make brownies. As for me, I have Crohn's disease, so I'm intolerant to pretty much everything under the sun, but I don't know, there's some things that I just eat anyways, but there are some things that I like actually really do try to stay away from, or else I know I'm gonna wind up in the fucking hospital, and we don't want that to happen. But I'll make a video about all that crazy bullshit in my life some other time. Okay, so now we got our brownie batter all nice and mixed. Oh, smells so good. Take take a look. Now, y'all know me, I love, love, love peanut butter. So I had to find a way to somehow incorporate peanut butter into this. So I'm going to be putting in these Reese's peanut butter cup. I keep wanting to call them Reese's peanut butter cups. These Reese's brand peanut butter chips. Just gonna fold them in. Oh my stars. I'm just really tempted to just take this whole thing and down the hatch, but I know better than that. Cool beans. Now, to transfer it all into my pan here. All right, so here we go. Just gonna carefully get all of it in there as much as I can. Pennies on the dollar, as my old boss would say. I will hear that in my head for the rest of my life. Gonna put you in the sink, baby. All right, now, spread out my brownie batter. Oh, I cannot wait to dig in. And I just can't wait to dig in. Welcome to the Vulgar Kitchen, where I like to pretend I'm on Broadway. Now I need my handy dandy oven mitt. Go Eagles. And into the oven. We'll see y'all soon. Now we're gonna let this bad boy bake in the oven for like 33 to 35 minutes. And away she goes. In the meantime, I'm gonna do a little bit of cleanup, get some bowls, and I'm gonna make a fantastic frosting to top my brownies with while my brownies are baking. God damn, who had diarrhea on the spatula again? So while my brownies are baking in the oven, I'm going to be making an awesome chocolate frosting. I've already melted one whole stick of butter, and everything else that I have here is 3 cups of powdered sugar, 2/3 cup of the unsweetened Hershey's cocoa powder, 1/3 cup of milk, and we're gonna be using a teaspoon of vanilla extract. All right, so first things first, I'm going to pour my melted butter stick into this bowl here. And now I'm gonna get a little spoon and I'm gonna stir in my cocoa powder. Oh my god, I'm just gonna give this a mix. Smells like chocolate. Perfect. Now I'm gonna alternately add my powdered sugar and my milk. Move these a little closer. Put my spoon away. Here, and again, I'm just gonna add a little bit at a time. I swear, this stuff is like, looks like cocaine, I swear. Not that I would know. All right, a little bit at a time. Here we go. Gonna start low so that it doesn't splatter all over me. Gonna add a little bit of my milk. Woo. Or a lot of it. Sides. Stay.
You smell chocolate.
Why do these things keep happening to me? Oh, it's everywhere. Oh, it's in my milk on my table. Oh, goodness. Gonna continue doing this. Looks good, smells good, and I made a goddamn mess everywhere. Gonna add just this last little bit of powdered sugar. See if this tastes better. This has to taste better. Ready? Oh yeah, much better. Into the sink. Gotta wash my goddamn hands. Looks like I wiped my butt with my hands. Jesus Christ. Put my other bowls in the sink. And unplug this. Safety first. this in a little bit. That looks fucking fantastic. At least if nothing else goes right, this went right, and that's all that matters, because all I need is a spoon and this stuff, and I will be one happy camper. Now, I just so happen to have, if I can find it, here it is. This guy. So once my brownies are done, I'm gonna let them cool for a little bit, and then I'm gonna smooth on my little frosting, and then I'm just gonna face plant into them because I can't wait. It already smells so delicious in here. 3.5 minutes to go, so we are making good time. In the meantime, I'm gonna kind of scoop this over, and it looks like somebody just took a dump. I mean, you probably can't really see that well, but there's just chunks of chocolate frosting everywhere. Ay, ay, ay. Oh, now I'm smudging it. At least my kitchen smells like delicious chocolate, so I'd rather it smell like chocolate than something else. Ooh. Oh my gosh. I better close this and put this away before white stuff goes flying everywhere and things start looking suspicious if the cops come. Not that the cops have any reason to come, but just in case. Okay, not that a little tape can't fix. All right, we conveniently have less than 10 seconds left, so I'm gonna get my towel and my cooling rack out. They look good. My towel. so good. You would not believe that there's no flour in here. It's so rich, so chocolatey. The peanut butter chips taste so good. And that frosting is to die for. I'm in heaven. Chocolate and peanut butter go so well together. It's just things like this that really make life worth living for. I'm being serious. Oh, look at that gooey. Oh. Oh! Got a little bit on me, folks. Wipe this up. Oh my god, that is all over me. I'm a child. I swear, I'm a child. It's probably still all over me, but you know what? I don't give a shit. This is so good, and it's gonna get all over me again. Mm. Oh, it's so good. This is super messy, super delicious. It's great. It's gluten-free. I would love for you guys to make this, and if you do, let me know what you think. Well, I'm gonna go, and I'm gonna cut the rest of these bad boys up and probably eat away my sorrows and just sit down with this entire thing and eat them all. YOLO. Alrighty guys, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and if you have any recipes you want me to try, comment down below and I will do my very best to make them. And I'm probably gonna make a fool of myself. I sure as hell made a damn mess today, so. But whatever, that's the fun of cooking. Anyways, again, I hope you guys enjoyed. And as always, I don't know when you're watching, so have a good morning, good day, good night, and goodbye. Get in my belly!